Hi everyone, this is Anne from Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to tell you how to get started with Adobe Dimension. So this is a package design that I created a few weeks ago, and I showed how to make this on Adobe Live. And if you want to see that, there's a link in my description. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about Dimension. To use it, you need a Creative Cloud membership that's been updated to the 2018 version. It's not free. It's part of Creative Cloud, so if you don't have that, you're kind of out of luck. But if you do, there are tons of free models out on Adobe Stock, so I'm gonna go ahead now and grab one of those to use with this design. So let's go out here to Adobe Stock. And I've got it set to 3D, you can change it to 3D here. And I'll just put in bottle to see what we come up with. Here are a lot of models that are already set up. If you're not seeing a model that's close to what you want, you can actually make your own OBJ model. That OBJ is the file extension, and you can save that from Cinema 4D or another modeling program. And I'm not very familiar with modeling, 3D modeling, so I have to buy ones off here or get the free ones. All of these across the top are free, and you can see that just by hovering. Here's a premium one. So if it says premium, that means you have to pay for it. But all these that don't say that, they're free and you can just download them to your computer. I have a number that I've already gotten, and I'll go ahead and save this to my computer. You can also save this to your library, and then it will pop right up in the library in Dimension. So that is really cool, but I never do it that way. I'm not really used to libraries. Probably shouldn't even be talking about them because I don't know much about them, but I just save everything to my computer and then you can just upload it into Dimension. So let's go over and get started in Dimension. Okay, so I'm gonna create a new project and it brings up this screen. We'll go to File, Import 3D Model, and then I'll just navigate to where that one is. It is in a zip file, so you'll have to double click, but I already did that. So I'm going to grab the bottle thick OBJ and open that. And it kind of just sticks it somewhere on your screen. It seems kind of random, but then you can position it using these four buttons down here. We have the orbit tool, the hand tool, the dolly tool, and the horizon tool. I'm going to use the hand tool to just pull it down like this. And the other tools will just move it around. So if you use this tool, you can see all the sides of it. The dolly tool will kind of zoom in and out on it. This tool allows you to change your horizon line. Okay, the first thing I want to do is make my bottle look a little more like a barbecue sauce bottle. So I'm going to use these tools up here to make that happen. First, I'll click on my bottle, which is a folder. Over here in the scene, you have something that kind of reminds me of layers, and this is how I think of these so that it doesn't confuse me. I'm going to keep just on this folder, and then we'll resize with the move tool. And you have some different options down here that you can hold and drag. This one will actually move it up. If you click over here on the resize tool, you have a similar looking triangle down here. If you pull this green, you can resize the top to make it a little bit shorter, and I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to make mine a little bit wider, a little kind of thin and wide. And now I'll use this to kind of pan it around so that it looks more like a barbecue sauce bottle. And that looks just about right to me. Okay, so we've got the size of the bottle. I think I might make the lid a little taller. I have to be clicked on the upper one. We'll use this tool to make it a little bit taller and a little bit thinner. Okay. All right, so I think I'm done making changes to my bottle. I will go ahead and make this look kind of like barbecue sauce. We've got bottle thick one, and bottle thick matte. So I want to get all the way down in there to bottle thick matte. And then I can change my base color. And I'm gonna change that to kind of a reddish orange, like this. It kind of looks like barbecue sauce. That is probably pretty close. Maybe a little more red, and not that much. All right, maybe a little darker. Okay, So my base color's changed, and now I want to make the bottle look a little less like glass. So I want to make it a little, I'll have a little bit of translucence, but I want it to mostly be opaque because you can't see through a bunch of sauce. I'll also change my lid color. Go to base color again for that. We'll go to color and I'll change it to kind of a bluish, a darker blue, right about there. So now it's time to place my image. We'll go to File, Import, Place Graphic as Decal. Now this is a common problem. If you place it on a group, which I do have it on the whole group, it's going to ask you to make a single selection. So it's saying, well, do you want to place it on the lid? Do you want to place it on the bottle? Pick one. So I'm going to go ahead and choose the bottle. So I've got that chosen, and now I'll do the same thing. All right, put that on there. And here it is. And it's already kind of squeezed it to match what I did to the bottle, which I don't want. I'm on the V tool now. And I'm going to go ahead and pull this down to be a perfect circle or as close as I can get, so I can have kind of a good starting point there. And now I want to resize. So I'll get on the resize button and make it quite a lot larger. Make it even bigger and possibly a little bit bigger. So graphic is there, but it is pretty dark. I'll change that in just a moment, but right now I want to put in an environment. So I'm going to choose one that's already here, but you can also do File, Import, Image as Background, and you can upload your own image there. So I'm going to go ahead and put this wood table back there. Okay, that looks pretty good. And now it's going to ask me, do I want to resize my canvas, create environmental light, match sunlight, and match camera perspective? I do want that, all of that, so I'm going to say okay. And it kind of moves it up and matches the background a little better. But sometimes it gets a little weird like this. So here's where we're going to change how this image is seen. So first I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. All right. I am going to move it down a little bit, like right about there. I'll probably cover up this image with some more bottles of Joanoni's barbecue sauce, but for right now, this will be fine. I noticed that this is a little dark. It's not really how I want my bottle to look. So to change those kinds of things, go to Environment, and you can up the intensity. We can look at sunlight, mess with that. So we can go to Bottle Thick Matte and change our glow to get a little more brightness in the image itself. And these are all things that I'm just kind of playing with right now. I don't really know which ones will do what I want. So I do like that a little better. Knock down the translucence a little bit. I'm going to change my base color to something a little darker. That looks better. Okay, I also went into Bottle Thick Decal and upped the metallicness so it gives it a little more brilliance. And the roughness can also change that way. You can also mess with the sunlight, and it makes it look really intense when you do this, but when you actually render it, it doesn't actually change it that much. So I'm going to rotate this around to match that plant back there, right about there. And now we'll go back and change the color. Sometimes when I change some things, it changes the color of some parts of my design, so I go back and fix those. I'm going to go back into the Bottle Thick Matte and change this color again to something even darker. Yeah, that's perfect. Okay, I think right now we're ready to render, but there's one more thing I want to change before doing that. Let's go to Environment under Properties. If you go all the way to the bottom, you have depth of field, and this is where you can set the focus range. Right now the focus range is set at 40, and that's the default. But you can set what part of the image you want to be the focus. So you can click on this button here and set your focal point. I'm going to do it right on the Joanoni's logo. And it will render based on that focal point. And that's what is going to be really in focus. Everything else will kind of be out of focus. So that is pretty cool. You can also increase the blur and those kinds of things. So I think we're ready to go. Let's go ahead and render this. When you're rendering, I really, really recommend putting on low, fast, and PNG. That will give you a small, fast, quick render. And if you decide you really like it, then you can go back and do a really long render and a really nice high quality render. So go ahead and hit render. And I'm going to replace the one that's already out there. And this does take some time for me to render the image that I'm going to show you here in a minute. It took about 5 minutes, so I'm not going to bore you with that, but I'll show you how it turned out here in a moment. Okay, and here's what it rendered as. And as you can see, the Joe Noni's is really in focus. And some of these things on the side are already getting out of focus, and that's because we set the focal point to be right here. So I think for this, I would just cover up this with another bottle of Joe Noni's and then put one over here. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching my video today. If you like this video, please click on the like button, and I'll see you guys next week. Thanks.